Good morning and welcome to my shop. This is Jim here in Rock Springs, Wyoming. I have a confession to make. I'm a toolaholic. Like most woodworkers, I enjoy good tools. I enjoy collecting them, but more than anything else, I really enjoy using them. And a good tool helps us produce, I think, a better end product. And in lathe tools, the old adage is very true, you do get what you pay for. Today I want to talk a little bit about a few lathe tools made by Doug Thompson at Thompson Lathe Tools. I will put a link down in the description to his website. Doug's a heck of a good guy. He's a wood turner who makes wood turning tools. Doug uses a CPM 10V and also a 15V powdered steel, which is triple heat treated to Rockwell 62, 64. And you can get all those particular specs from his website. But what I'd like to share with you today is a little bit about his tools in general, his handles, and what maybe sets them apart from lesser expensive tools that you buy. For us as wood turners, I think it's very important for us to finally come to the conclusion that a gouge, a scraper, whatever tool it may be using is a consumable. That being said, we need to know it's going to wear out and we're going to use it up and we're going to need to sharpen it often. I find that a dull tool is a dangerous tool and a sharp tool is a safe tool. I enjoy working with the quality of Doug's tools as compared to others that I have from other manufacturers. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about the other manufacturers. This is a review of some of Doug's tools. And again, this is subject to my experience. Your experiences may be different. You may have a favorite tool or tool manufacturer that you use. A few things that I find important to me in a lathe tool. Number one, how long does it hold an edge? Number two, how easy or difficult is it to sharpen? And number three, you know, how long is the flute? In all honesty, that's going to tell us a lot about how much use we can expect out of that tool. When you look at the average tool, if you look at a Benjamin's Best or some of the others that are out there, yes, they're inexpensive. They're made out of high-speed steel. And we'll talk about some differences in that, non-scientific differences. But what I want you to notice first is when you buy a tool from Doug, at least, the flute is typically a minimum of 6 inches long. On his larger 5/8 and 3/4 bowl gouges, the flute is actually 7 inches long. Different flute configurations, and we won't go into the which one is the best flute configuration. This again is just a review of Doug's tools. First, I want to show you what I find is a typical half-inch bowl gouge from the manufacturer. You know, we get these sets of tools from different places and from Amazon and eBay and different places, and we find that probably one of the sellers that's out there that a lot of people, a lot of turners use and have, and I use them and find them to be decent tools is the Benjamin's Best. Now, it's a high-speed steel. They don't tell you which high-speed steel it is. Doug's is a CPM 10V. Now, I want you to notice, I'm going to try to get in close enough for you to see the flute in this one. Now, I'm going to show you a used 12V or a half-inch V bowl gouge. This is one of my favorite bowl gouges. And what I'm talking about in this flute length, you can see here, as you compare the lengths, the usable lengths of these two tools. While you may pay $20, $25 for this one, you may pay $50 for this tool, the reality is, you're getting a lot more usable tool. You're getting this one, again, has been used quite a bit. You're going to get a 6-inch flute here versus typically a 3 or a 4-inch flute here. Another difference is With this tool, I find that when I'm rough turning a green bowl, that I'm going to the grinder pretty often to keep a nice, keen, sharp edge on this tool. But with Doug's, I'm finding that I go to the grinder probably, I would guess I go to the grinder 1/3 as often. To me, that's important. Not only that, it's the quality of the edge. With this steel, I'm able to get a very, very, very fine edge. It is great tool steel. The flutes are very smooth. They are very efficient. The tools are uniform. And I find the tool quality just excellent. The finish, you know, everything, you know, what do you say? It's just what it needs to be. The shank sizes are standardized, so they'll fit in any of your handles that are 1/4, 3/8, 1/2, 5/8, 3/4. And they're just really good tools. Doug makes a lot of different tools, and I'm going to show you a 3/8 spindle gouge. This is just the standard 3/8 spindle gouge that, you know, all of us are used to using. And for comparison, this is another Benjamin's Best that we'll look at. And here is a brand new one, actually from Packard Woodworks. It's the Hamlet spindle gouge. May have came from Craft Supply. And again, we'll get up a little closer so that you can see the differences in the flute lengths. Now this 3/8 spindle gouge, it's been used a good bit. When we bring this one, again, I think this is a Benjamin's Best, you're going to notice here a substantial difference in the length of the flute, nearly twice as much. That means while I'm buying this tool, not only am I getting twice the flute, therefore twice the length of cutting time, but also what I'm getting is a better steel, a higher grade of steel. That'll let me go between sharpenings, and therefore the tool will last longer. Well, a lot of people says, well, if you're going to sharpen, you're going to sharpen. Number one, if I'm sharpening this tool 5 times in a day versus 10 times in a day, by the time I leave my lathe, stop my work, the creative flow and process stops. We know what that's like. Go to the grinder, come back, getting back into that, getting back where we were with that train of thought and what we were doing. To me, the quality tool and the ability to hold its edge keeps me at the lathe. Keeps me at the lathe longer, keeps me creating, keeps me there where I want to be, not at the grinder. Now, a few other tools I want to highlight from Doug, and you can go on his website. Again, I'll put that link in the description. We've looked at his 3/8 spindle gouge. We've looked at his half-inch V-ground, V-grooved V-flute. I can even say it right in a minute. Also, Doug makes great scrapers. This is the V10. And it is in the 1 1/8 inch. This is an inside scraper. I love this. It's nice, thick, got a good cross section, holds its edge, gets a nice burr, does a really good job in just a regular flat on the rest scraping. But also if you want to turn it up and do some shear scraping, does a great job on that. Again, you know, I like the wooden handles. I guess maybe I'm a little old school, but I'm going to show you something I really do like from Doug as well. If you look up Robo Hippie or Reed Gray at robohippie.net, he does a great video on one of my favorite turning tools. Whether I'm doing spindle work or doing bowl work, this fluteless gouge that Doug has is absolutely one of the best tools to have in your arsenal as a wood turner. This is a finished cut tool. It will rival, gets very close to in spindle work, even the finish of a skew. And this does a really, really good job. He's got them in different sizes. I happen to have a half inch and the 3/8. And while I'm there, on Doug's site, he also sells round tool blanks in the 10V material. He sells the 1/4, 3/8, and 1/2 inch. And I used a piece of the 1/4 inch to make a 1/4 inch fluteless gouge. This is a tremendous little tool for working on detail work, the bottoms of small boxes, inside the lids of small boxes. You know that little nib we have that kind of haunts us? Great little tool for that. Out of a piece of his 1/2 inch tool stock, I made a nice little round skew. A very nice little tool, getting in, rolling some beads. And then I go to probably the most used tools in spindle work for me are the detail gouges. These are a little bit shallower flute than the regular gouges, giving them a little more rigidity, kind of double grind that off at the back. This is the 1/2, the 3/8, and the 1/4 inch. Very nice little tools. Now this brings us to the next thing, is the handles by Doug Thompson. Now he'll personalize them for you. If you'll give him the information, he'll put your name on them. But these handles are really nice. They come with a plug in the ends that you can remove, adding shot. But what I like about Doug's handles that are different than the other handles that you find on the internet is they are squared off with rounded corners. And these don't roll off your lathe or your bench or wherever you may put them. They're available in different lengths. Also, we'll see if we can get this on the video. They come with some steel shot in them and a movable disc on the inside that you can add to or take away from and balance this out. This one happens to be on a 3/8 U bowl gouge. I love this to get down in the bottom of a bowl, that transition that's down in there. But these handles are really, really nice. They're heavy. They're made out of an extruded aluminum. You can read about those. Again, the plug that comes out of the end of the handle fits back in. It's got an O-ring seal. Again, you can add to or take away from the shot. You can move the disc that's inside. You can take the shot out. And what is really nice about that is, if you take the shot out, maybe put in a little Ziploc bag, you're going to a show, you can take your tool out, flip your tool and put it in, and you can ride around with a protected tip, but more importantly, it's not exposed to maybe get you when you're not looking. The noses of the tools are turned and tapered. I like that as well. Typically, all of his large handles have 2 grub screws. They're a standard size for a 5/32 Allen wrench and a 3/8 Allen wrench to take the plug out of the bottom of the larger handles. So I guess that does it as far as kind of a mini review of Doug's tools. I find them superior quality, superior workmanship, and I've tried from Taylor's to Sorby's to all the different ones in turning, and I have just had really good luck and experience with Doug's tools. They keep me at the lathe. They keep me turning. Now I need to add something at this point. I bought these tools at full retail. Doug didn't give me any of these tools in exchange for any kind of review or information. I did this because I believe in what I use to be a good quality product from Doug and Thompson Lathe Tools. Thank you for tuning in. If you like the video, click like. And if you would, hit subscribe. And I hope this has been informative to you when it comes to maybe picking your next set of lathe tools. Again, this is Jim, a toolaholic in Rock Springs, Wyoming. Thanks for tuning in. God bless you.